Let's suppose a particular illness is much more likely to be observed in people taking a particular drug than those who don't. Specifically, if we know that the prevalence of the illness is about 8%, then for those who take the drug, the probability of the illness increases to 28%, compared to those who don't take the drug, for whom the prevalence of the illness is 4%. So it's 7 times more likely in those who take the drug. So if we know that a person has the illness, can we conclude that it's almost certain that it was caused by the drug? Well, no, because if they didn't take the drug, then it's certain that the illness was not caused by the drug. In fact, if we assume that in this population about 20% of the people take the drug, then if we observe a person with the illness, all we can conclude is that there's a good chance that they took the drug. But of course, the illness can be caused by other factors, such as an immune deficiency. In fact, it's most likely that it requires a combination of both to be really certain that a person will get the illness. Now let's look at what we can learn about both the probability of taking a drug and the immune deficiency, knowing that a person has the illness. So we reset the model. So in the population, there's a 20% chance that a person takes drugs, also a 20% chance that the person has an immune deficiency. If we observe a person with the illness, then knowing that they had the illness increases the probability of both taking the drug and having an immune deficiency. Now, if we know that the person definitely took the drug, we run the model again. Although the probability of immune deficiency decreased because the illness is partly explained by taking the drug, it's still very high. It's still very likely that they have an immune deficiency. So to properly answer the question of what is the probability that the illness was caused by the drug, we actually have to answer a counterfactual question. Specifically, knowing that a person has the illness, what's the probability that they would have avoided the illness if they hadn't taken the drug? And to answer that question, we've got to create a model which incorporates both the real world and a counterfactual world where we can change something that happened in the real world. So in the real world, we know the person has the illness. And from that, we learnt that it was likely they took the drug and also likely that they had this immune deficiency. So we've learnt those probabilities by having observed they had the illness in the real world. Now, if additionally we know they definitely took the drug, then, as we saw, there's still a high probability that they have this immune deficiency. So we've already learnt this probability of the immune deficiency in this person, irrespective of whether this person takes the drug or not. So in the counterfactual world, i.e. where we run the world again and don't know whether they take the drug or not, then the probability that they get the illness is already quite a bit higher than the average person. It's gone up to 26% compared with the original 8%. If in this counterfactual alternative world, they take the drug again, then because of uncontrollable chance, there's still a chance that they'll avoid the illness. It's about 26%. However, if in this alternative counterfactual world they don't take the drug, then the probability that they avoid illness goes to about 86%. So that's a 60% change. So we could reasonably conclude that the probability their illness was caused by the drug is about 60%.